The next customer I'd like to introduce to you comes from a very different industry. That is Carlos Barreto, CIO of Petrobras. Carlos, welcome to the stage.
Thank you, Mr. Mihir.
Carlos and his team flew
nice
from Brazil. Here. Thank you for flying in.
Sure.
Last time we were talking, you were in China and I was in Africa climbing Kilimanjaro at 19,000 feet.
Yes, quite interesting.
This is much easier.
Much easier.
Yeah, in person.
That is correct.
Yeah. Carlos, maybe you start with introducing you and Petrobras to all of us.
Sure, sure. My name is Carlos Barreto. I'm the CIO of Petrobras. And for you that, if you haven't heard of Petrobras before, we are the largest energy company in South America and in Brazil by extension. Our company is 70 years old, and we are known for our ultra deep water oil and gas exploration. Petrobras has roughly 45,000 employees directly and another 150 third parties that we work with. We are heavy users of technology, and we have been the leading patent creators in South America for the last 10 years.
I didn't know that.
So we will continue to use technology for a long time to see.
Fantastic. Again, you are in a place where you see so many systems, so many applications. What is top in the CIO agenda for you to, for this year and next?
For this year and next, okay. Let me start with the long run.
Yeah. Right?
I think the honest answer for that question is we don't know.
Okay.
Right. There are so many emerging technologies in the marketplace right now, so many potential for disrupture, and so many of those technologies are merging into themselves. That is very hard to say we're going to be in 1, 2, or 3 years. What I can tell you for sure is that our approach to technology is going to remain the same. We're definitely going to be looking into those new technologies, the way they're emerging, and how we match them against our business needs. So that's for sure.
Okay.
And for the short answer, for the 6 months that you mentioned, what I want to be doing, and I want to instill the thunder for my colleague that will be speaking later.
Yeah, they have a keynote later, so make sure to listen to them.
Exactly. I don't want to steal the thunder from him, but in 6 months from now, what I'm going to be doing is I want to pick up the phone.
Yeah.
I want to call my boss and tell her, your IT team just saved you $1 billion.
I like it.
So
I'm
going to be doing the virtual mic drop.
And ask for a raise or
something. Exactly, something like that.
So tell us what you're doing now. Give us a, if you're going to do that in 6 months, give us a maybe preview, a little bit of it.
Absolutely.
What you've been up to. Automation, generative AI, AI, everything,
As you well know, we have been working on a generative AI project in our corporate side of the house at Petrobras. We have used generative AI and automation to come up with a winning case on taxes that will save Petrobras $120 million per year. And that is just the beginning.
Yeah.
Because we did that for just one of the many taxes that we pay.
Yeah.
Petrobras is a company that pays $54 billion every year. Yeah. And you may say that 120 is just very little, but we are just basically tackling one of the taxes that we pay. So we're going to be scaling that into a much broader program.
How long it took you to save, to create something that saves $120 million?
You definitely want to steal his thunder. But
okay, I'm sorry.
It's all right.
Yeah.
It's going to be, well, we did that in 3 weeks.
That's incredible.
It is incredible. It is incredible. And I don't want to give people the impression
that come on.
Thank you. Thank you. Thanks to our team. We did it all in 3 weeks, and I don't want to give people the impression that it was easy.
Yeah.
Because we have very dedicated people working on it, people very knowledgeable from the automation anywhere side of the house and as well with Petrobras.
Yeah.
But in fact, the most challenging part of it was to come up with a bot that would compile all of our spreadsheets. Don't tell anyone that we had spreadsheets. But we basically struggled a little bit to, you know, to put that all together. And then the easy part was to put the generative AI.
Yeah.
I didn't know before that, but generative AI now seems to be like an API on the cloud.
Yeah.
An API
call
on the cloud.
Easy to do,
Easy to move.
3 weeks.
3 weeks. And we did it in 2 weeks.
It's amazing. So. Tell us, where does this go? You're on this journey. What automation's next? Are you going to do it across other departments? What is the vision?
Absolutely. Now that we have a poster child, we need to beef up our team.
Yeah.
We need to make sure that the people who are going to be coming knocking on our doors, we're going to be able to help them out. But I think the first step that we need to take is to scale that within the taxation group that we have at Petrobras. Yeah. All those $54 billion, they represent a huge opportunity for us coming forward.
Yeah.
We want to tackle that challenge first, and then we want to scale to the rest of the corporate side of Petrobras. We're already users of AI on exploration and refineries. Yeah,
you've been for a while.
Yeah, we've been for a while.
You mentioned you're the largest register of patents.
So exactly, exactly.
Yeah.
But
How about taking this to the many knowledge workers across different departments, different functions, eventually?
Yes.
Yeah.
I think there's a great opportunity for us doing some of the AI, the generative AI work on HR, on the procurement side of Petrobras, which is also very demanding of the type of technology. So I think we have a very ripe environment for the taking of this type of
to across the department.
Yes.
Thank you so much for sharing, and
thank you.
What an amazing story.
Thank you. Appreciate
it. Thank you very much.
Appreciate
Be sure
it.
To.
Thank you. Guys. Thank you.